I just want to begin today with Ephesians chapter 6 again, a little on prayer, verse 18. Ephesians chapter 6, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all the saints. Amen. Praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit. Amen. Here in Ephesians 6, it is talking about our armor for spiritual warfare and the fact that prayer is so important. Our time with Jesus and praying for ourselves, praying for our families, praying for the church, praying for the city, praying for the nation is so important. Say it's important. And it says praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit. Praying in the Spirit. Amen. And so especially if you have the gift of tongues, you should pray in the gift of tongues, because that is praying in the Spirit. And we don't understand what we are praying in the Spirit, but God is doing great things as we pray from our spirit. God is accomplishing His will. Amen. Shout hallelujah. If we pray with our understanding, we can achieve only what we understand. But if we pray in the Spirit, if we pray in the Spirit realm, now we in the Spirit realm, we achieve great things. Things that we don't see or even understand. In the name of Jesus, in the Spirit realm, we do things in the Spirit realm because we live in a spirit world. We are living here, but there is a spirit world that is more real than the natural world. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Amen. And that's why we should pray in the Spirit. That's why we should pray in the Spirit. And so when you pray in tongues, you're automatically praying in the Spirit and you are achieving things in the realm of the Spirit. Amen. Give a clap of praise for Jesus Christ. Amen. And your prayer is very important. Say, my prayer is important. Turn also to Matthew chapter 26, verse 41. Watch and pray, lest you enter into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. Amen. The spirit is willing, but the flesh is weak. Why do we pray? Why do we pray? Jesus himself, before he went to the cross, he went to pray to receive strength from the Father. And his disciples were sleeping. And Jesus comes to them and says, could you not pray? Could you not watch with me for 1 hour? And then he says, the spirit is willing, because our spirit connects to God. Our spirit is willing. We always in our spirit, because we are born again, we want to pray, we want to follow God. But our flesh is weak. So when Jesus says pray, he's saying when you pray, your spirit will be strengthened, when your flesh will be strengthened. Your flesh will not overpower your spirit. Amen. If you want strength in your spirit and your flesh to follow God and to do the things He has called you to do, then we should pray. Because otherwise, your spirit may be willing. Yes, I want to. Yes, I want to, of course. But your flesh will draw you somewhere else. Your flesh will draw you to sleep. Your flesh will draw you to do something other than spiritual stuff. And you will be somewhere else. But Jesus is saying you pray. And when you pray, your spirit will be strong. Your body will be strong. Your mind will be strong. And then through that, you can achieve things for God. And you can change things in your life. Amen. Amen. Otherwise, we try things, but we fail. And that's why Jesus is saying your spirit is willing. Even now, all of us, our spirits are willing, but our flesh is weak. If you're not, but how do you strengthen and how do you make your flesh follow your spirit? Are you understanding? Your flesh should follow your spirit. not the other way. Your spirit should not follow your flesh. And if you want to live like that, you should pray and strengthen yourself. As I said a few weeks back, when you pray, you receive strength or you receive the power of the Holy Spirit. When you receive the power of the Holy Spirit, you can pray more. When you pray more, you receive the power of the Holy Spirit. When you receive the power of the Holy Spirit, you can pray more. So it's one thing. You cannot separate it. Amen. The way I understand it, or the picture the Lord gave me today for as I prayed for prayer is, prayer, when you pray, praying is like building a fortress around you. It's like building a fortress around us. When you pray, it is like building a fortress around your life, a fortress around your family. See, the devil wants to attack us. The devil wants to bring us down. The devil wants to destroy us. But when we pray, we are building a fortress. And we know in the olden times, kings would always, all kingdoms had fortresses. We see in the Bible. When Israelites went to the city of Jericho, Jericho had a fortress. That's why Israelites could not enter easily. Babylon had a fortress. Assyria had a fortress. Every city had a fortress, a huge fortress, so the enemy could not come in easily. The reason the enemy can come into our lives sometimes easily is because there is no fortress. But when we build a fortress, it's very difficult for the enemy to attack. And so prayer, when you pray, you are building a fortress. When you pray in the spirit, you are building a fortress. You're covering yourself. And then it's difficult for the enemy to come inside. Amen. Hallelujah. And so never think your prayer, whether you may pray for 1 minute, it's fine. But if you, as you spend more time, the more you, as you spend time in the presence of God, remember, you're building and building and building that fortress. One level after another, you're raising it up, you're building it up, and you're not allowing the devil to penetrate into your life. And so we need to spend time in prayer, building that fortress. Building that fortress. Say, I'm building a fortress. Amen. How will you build the fortress? Through prayer. Spend time in prayer. It will be difficult for the enemy to come inside. If the fortress is not there, the devil will just come in. Amen. And God wants, in these days, God wants us to rise in the area of prayer, build our prayer lives, so that we will be strong in order to do the things of God. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Amen. So build a fortress. When you pray, pray strongly for the church. Build a fortress around the church. Build a fortress around the church. Don't just be quiet. This is our church. This is your church. Build a fortress around the church with your prayer. And the enemy will not be able to get in. Build a fortress around your job. Build a fortress around your children with prayer. And the enemy will not be able to take them. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Amen. This is a weapon. And of when we talk about spiritual warfare and weapons, you understand that the simple things we do. Prayer is not only asking God for things, but prayer is building a fortress. And when you do that, you will win in that battle and in the spiritual warfare. You will win because you are covered yourself. You've covered yourself. Amen. Shout hallelujah. Amen. He will give us knowledge. When you pray, he will give you wisdom. When you sit to pray, it's not just talking, but God is giving you something. Are you listening? It's not simply closing your eyes and meditating. See, for most people, prayer is meditation. Close your eyes and sit and meditate. Or just talk to God. No, it's a time when you're connecting with God. It's not just meditation. It's connecting with the Almighty God. It's connecting with your Father. And when you connect with your Heavenly Father, you receive knowledge. You receive wisdom. You receive revelation. When you pray, you receive these things. Let your spirit be stirred up to pray and to pray and to pray more, because prayer and sitting with God is a powerful time, because you're connecting with the living God. You're building a fortress. Amen. When you pray, all this is happening if you're really sitting with God. Amen. It's not just talking. God is imparting to you. Amen. Are you listening? When you sit with Jesus, He is giving you, He's blessing you, He's talking to you, He's doing things in your life. Amen. Give a clap of praise for Jesus. ಪಡಲಿ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡುತ್ತಿರುವ ಆ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮ್ಮ ಆತ್ಮವು ಬಲಪಡಲಿ, ನಿಮ್ಮ ಶರೀರವು ಬಲಪಡಲಿ, ನೀವು ಇನ್ನೂ ಹೆಚ್ಚಾಗಿ ಅಧಿಕವಾಗಿ ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡುವಂತೆ ನಿಮಗೆ ಬಲ ಸಿಗಲಿ. ಈ ಸಮಯದಲ್ಲಿ, ಈ ದಿನಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ನಿಮಗೆ ಬಲ ಸಿಗಲಿ, ಇನ್ನು ಅಧಿಕವಾಗಿ ಆತ್ಮದಲ್ಲಿ ಆರಾಧನೆ ಮಾಡಲು, ಪ್ರಾರ್ಥನೆ ಮಾಡಲು, ದೇವರಿಗೆ ಕಾರ್ಯಗಳನ್ನು ಸಾಧಿಸಲು ಇನ್ನೂ ಅಧಿಕವಾಗಿ ಬಲ ಸಿಗಲಿ ಯೇಸು ಕ್ರಿಸ್ತರ ನಾಮದಲ್ಲಿ. ಆಮೆನ್. ರಿಸೀವ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೇ ಐ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಇಟ್. ಸೇ ಐ ರಿಸೀವ್ ಇಟ್. And give a clap of praise for Jesus. Amen.